they gave us. It's 28 minutes after one on a Saturday arvo here at Triple J's, and we're taking you through till two today. And a lady who's been spending a bit of time overseas doing, well, we're going to find out what, is Fiona Horn, who joins me on the line now from LA. Hello, Fiona.
Hello.
How are you doing today?
Oh, great, thank you. Finished dinner. Lovely.
Well, it is indeed the evening in Los Angeles, and I believe you've been chomping down on a bit of a carob mint cookie.
Carob mint vegan cookie from my favourite vegan food place, Real Food Daily. So very happy girl right now, very full stomach.
Very nice. Now, Triple J listeners would know you from your days in Def FX, but you've been doing a little bit of stuff in LA over the last few years and living there for a while. What exactly have you been up to in Los Angeles?
I've been pretty busy. I've had a number of books published over here, and I've just done a new book deal with Simon Schuster. You know, I write books about witchcraft, so pretty much every year I'm writing another book, and I'm very excited with this new deal I've just done with them. And I finished two films this year that have set for theatrical release, and I was in a television show here last year that did quite well and ended up seeing myself on billboards all over the country, which was kind of a trip. And I've got a regular radio show that's national here now, and a spellcasting show where people call in for spells. And I do that with Lisa Gibbons. I don't know if anyone there would know who she is.
From Entertainment Tonight.
Yeah. So Lisa and I partner up and do that. And, there's a bunch of good things coming up. Looks like I'm going to be working on a film with Nicolas Cage and Neil LaBute, The Wicker Man, which is a remake of...
A classic sort of horror small-town story, isn't it?
Yeah, it looks like I'll be heading off to Vancouver to do that when I get back from Australia.
So you've just been doing a couple of things in the last couple of years.
I know, 100 million things.
It's good. It's interesting to sort of see how much people kind of get done when they're in a different environment. Do you think that you wouldn't have been able to do all of that stuff? I guess probably the more film and television stuff, not as easy to do in Australia. But in terms of writing books about witchcraft and stuff, do you find that living in LA, it's a little bit more of an easier environment to do that in?
Well, to be honest, my publisher's in Australia, Random House, and my publisher, Jane Paul Freeman, has been, you know, Australia gave me my break with my writing when my band broke up like 7 years ago. So I have, you know, I'm still with Jane and still with Random House and still hugely grateful and excited about the opportunities of being published in Australia. And but, you know, I mean, when you come overseas, I think I'd had quite a long career in Australia with the band, and then I hosted a couple of television shows and, you know, for Channel 9 and Channel 10, and it was like I did Ground Zero for Channel 10 and Channel 9 was Party, and then I worked with Russell Gilbert Live and a bunch of things. But you get to a point where you go, all right, what next? And you've hit this kind of level of what you can achieve. And in Australia, people go, well, haven't you done enough? You know, why don't you get married and have a family? I'm like, I come here and they're like, you've done all that and you want to do more? Great, go for it. And
absolutely,
there's a real championing of the entrepreneurial spirit here, which is why I love being here.
But you are heading back to Australia next week as a part of a bit of a different spoken word tour around a bunch of sort of band venues. Can you tell us a bit about why you're coming back home to do this tour?
I'm doing a tour called One Enchanted Evening, and it's based on, it's kind of a cross between, I don't know, I was trying to think of what it's a cross between, but maybe it's a cross between a Henry Rollins spoken word tour with an Anthony Robbins personal motivation tour and one of my witchcraft workshops. So it's essentially spoken word, but I will be demonstrating spells and talking about how you can make magic work in your life and live the life that you dream. Because if nothing else, I would hope in the extraordinary life that I have led and the very many ways I've expressed my creativity and made a living from my creativity and got to continue growing and evolving as a person, I would hope that, you know, I mean, I turn 40 next year, and a lot of people at this age are starting to think, oh, you know, my past is longer than my future, and I'm just thinking I'm only just beginning. And I would hope that if people come along to the tour, along to the evenings, that they will not only enjoy themselves but take away a feeling of personal empowerment that would allow them to achieve their goals and dreams and know that they can the way that I have.
Doing, I guess, spells on radio, doing them in band venues, I guess a lot of people's idea about witchcraft is that it's something that needs to be done at a certain place, at a clearing in a forest, or it's a very sort of antiquated idea about witchcraft and what goes on, or you need to it needs to have a certain environment and have a certain sort of something in the air when spells take place. But it seems like what you're doing is taking it back to a very kind of, not an everyday level, but something that just about everyone can do. Is that kind of what you want to do with the spoken word tour?
Well, you bring up a very good point because you mentioned forests, and you know, as a witch, any witch would believe and acknowledge nature as sacred and as a profoundly empowered place and space, and this extraordinary earth we live in, this incredible biosphere we're a part of, is magically empowered, and we can tangibly experience that and enjoy it. So, but at the same time, I mean, creating magic in your life can happen anywhere. In this very modern urban environment that we live in, you carry your sacred space in your heart, and you can kind of express that wherever you need to or want to, whether you're sitting at your work desk, whether you're sitting on the bus. I mean, when I was a witchling and doing all my visualization exercises 20 years ago, I was getting a bus from Manly Beach to, where was I going, North Sydney. I managed a gymnasium, and I get the 144, and I do all my visualization exercises on the bus at 6 in the morning, like imagining blue circles appearing in the middle of the bus, or erasing buildings, or turning leaves of trees from green to pink.
Fantastic.
So you can do it anywhere, but I think what I'm really hoping with the tour is that people who come along, like I said, we'll have a great night, we'll have an entertaining night, but also learn something that can really positively empower their lives, and that they can share that sense of joy and empowerment with others.
And there'll be plenty of chances for people to see you when you fly to Australia next week to do a bunch of spoken word shows.
I'm charging it up now. It's a long trip. I've plugged in my broomstick. It's got to have like a 48-hour charge on it.
Fantastic. I hope you've got a car seat cover for that broomstick. It's pretty cold at the moment in Australia. You've got to keep yourself warm.
My favourite joke, but I'm not going to say it because it's really rude. Maybe I'll say it on my tour.
You're playing on, not exactly playing, but performing on Wednesday the 20th of July at Ruby's Lounge in Belgrave in Victoria, Thursday the 21st at the Northcote Social Club in Melbourne, Friday the 22nd of July at the Rest Point Hotel Casino in Hobart. On Saturday the 23rd, Fiona Horn will be at Fowler's Live in Adelaide. On the 24th, the Sunday at the Clarendon Guesthouse in Katoomba. Thursday the 28th of July at the Southport RSL on the Gold Coast. The Marquee in Sydney is where you can catch Fiona Horn on Friday the 29th of July, and finishing up at Club G in Newcastle on Saturday the 30th of July. Going to be some pretty interesting shows. If you say it's Henry Rollins mixed with a bit of Anthony Robbins and a little bit of witchcraft, I reckon that's more than enough fodder for people to get along and see Fiona Horn. And I thought that we might wind back to those days oh so many years ago when you were with Def FX, and Triple J listeners voted your song into the Hottest 100 of 1997. It was a song called I'll Be Your Magic. Do you still think, you know, happy thoughts about Def FX, Fiona?
You know, this will probably bring a tear to my eye hearing this, but there'll be some surprises at the actual event.
Interesting.
Share with people. So any fans of Def FX might enjoy the night too.
Fantastic. Good on you, Fiona. Thanks for chatting to us today at Triple J. See you, mate.
Thanks. Bye. Look no further, I watch your DNA.
If you look up.